You know, you got to love the Bakersfield Dome. You know, it's got a lot of history in that building. APW did some shows there back in 2002, 2003, in that era, all the way to 2008. But before APW did shows there, Mike LaBelle, one of the regional promoters, he used to do SoCal in L.A. Bakersfield was on his tour, and they had a circuit. And you know, I think Bakersfield Dome, they used to do like every week. And if you've never been to that building and you just walk in, and if you've been into any old school buildings, and I've been into a few of them, Phoenix Madison Square Garden was huge with me. Portland Sports Arena, run by Don Owens, was a bowling alley converted into an arena. I used to joke around all the time about Bakersfield Dome that, you know, heck, I'd love for APW to just pick up that building and transport it over here and put it somewhere on the Nimitz between Oakland and San Jose. That place is a classic building. I hope they never tear that down. The sad part is they tear a lot of buildings down like that. You're just an amateur. You can try as hard as you can, but you can't handle us. I'm waving at the pick and signing autographs. I'm always in first place, you always in the back. Homie, I'm all pro. And you're just an amateur. You can try as hard as you can, but you can't handle us. I'm waving at the pick and signing autographs.
APW faithful, welcome to another exciting edition of All Pro Wrestling Gym Wars. I'm JJ Purdom alongside my broadcast colleague Shane Stoley, and we're coming to you from the Bakersfield Dome.
That's right, this place is closing down pretty soon, and one last time, All Pro Wrestling and Vendetta Pro Wrestling putting on a fantastic show with those unified tag team titles on the line as Brian Tannen and Sir Samurai take on Suke.
Should be a barn burner. Also in one-on-one action, a rematch from the Young Lions Cup. J.R. Kratos, that man beast, takes on the destroyer of man, Damien Grundy.
And looking here at the screen, I can't help but notice the absence of Matthew Thiel. And I had to jump in here at the last minute. I wasn't planning on being here, and they called me up and said, Matthew Thiel's not here.
Matthew got stuck in a parade. Also, the main event in the Bakersfield Dome, the APW Universal Heavyweight Championship on the line as the champion, Timothy Thatcher, defends against former WWE superstar, the Masterpiece, Chris Masters.
This is going to be a fantastic match, an amazing opportunity for Chris Masters.
Ladies and gentlemen, our opening contest is a tag team match.
Joseph Duncan down there to bring in the action. We got a tag team title match to start things off here, JJ.
The championship's on the line here in the Bakersfield Dome, and the crowd evenly split. They like both teams, but you got to get the home field advantage to the champions, the APW Vendetta Pro Unified Tag Champion, Suke.
Of course, All Pro Wrestling has some tremendous history here at the Bakersfield Dome, and many other promotions as well, of course. But, I mean, especially All Pro Wrestling has done some amazing things here. Of course, we've had R-Truth here, so many talented guys. Al Snow, amazing title matches. MPT versus JJ Perez here in the Dome for the internet title. Amazing stuff.
Well, we are looking forward to an amazing tag team title match in the very last night here at the Bakersfield Dome. What an historic night for APW to have championships on the line.
of course, with Suke and, going up against the reformed Honor Society. Of course, you know, we haven't seen the Honor Society here in All Pro Wrestling yet. This is really our first opportunity to see how Sir Samurai operates within the confines of this with this faction.
The Honor Society has been a well-respected name in the NorCal professional wrestling scene for quite some time. And for it to be reformed with such a young, hot talent like this Brian Tannen, alongside somebody with the experience and the knowledge of the smartest man on the APW roster, you just got to give it up for a team like this.
So can you tell me a little bit about the Honor Society, just for the benefit of those at home that might not know about it?
The Honor Society was started at SPW, Supreme Pro Wrestling, one of our sister companies here in California, and they have had numerous of the greatest techs. Here we go.
Dropkick. Suke with a big dropkick.
I was just going to say that Timothy Thatcher at one time was one of the members of the Honor Society, a respected member, and came up and started his career as a member under Sir Samurai.
Of course, Sir Samurai trying to lead things here. Suke has got that purple purple.
Tsunami just getting right on those nipples. I thought I'd never say that. Oh, and he just hip-tossed him with his nipples.
It's $1,000 in therapy right there, JJ.
For me or for Samurai?
Yeah, either way.
And Sparky Ballard, our official for this Unified Tag Team Championship match.
He's going to have his hands full with this one. Of course, already admonishing Suke for starting things off a little bit underhandedly. I'm not sure where Suke is coming from with this one.
And you can see there's been a little bit of damage. Sometimes there's a lot of nerves that are connected to your
area.
I was going to say areolas, but it just sounds so funny to talk about that in a pro wrestling.
Oh, here we go!
And just a house of fire, the Honor Society taking it to the champions.
Of course, Samurai lovely came with that big forearm.
Here, a little meeting of the mind. Suke. Oh, wait a second. Suke with a little tag team tandem maneuvers. And using Caden Anthony's feet as weapons, and down go both the Honor Society members. And Tsunami and Anthony a little worse for wear, a little dizzy after all that spinning.
Tsunami looked like about to lose his pants too.
Well, it's hard for the champion to keep it up. He's working so hard in the ring right now. And after spinning all over the place, it looked like a tilt-a-whirl going on.
Definitely some innovative maneuvers here today. I didn't expect to see that. Of course, Samurai, smartest man in professional wrestling, was able to duck that first one, but they were able to, Tsunami was able to hit him in the back of the head with Caden's legs that second time around.
Well, that innovation is what has taken Suke to the tag team championship. And keep in mind that each one of these men have vaunted singles careers. At one time, Tsunami was the Vendetta Pro Heavyweight Champion.
But Caden Anthony, really a tag team specialist. You know, in addition to teaming with Tsunami, he's teamed with Billy Blade in the past as part of a Mortal Fear. Numerous time tag team champion all over California. And of course, right here in All Pro Wrestling as well, they held those tag team titles for quite some time.
The Rock of Love, absolutely. Of which Billy Blade is still on tour, by the way. I don't know if tickets are still on sale.
It's a perpetual tour. Yeah.
Duck over the clothesline. Tsunami, drives the back elbow. And Samurai is just scouting each one of those. Up and over, you would think that he'd try something different. Going to the well. Okay, Tsunami just actually backed out. Samurai, he's caught in a rut right now.
Running a marathon there in the ring.
Anthony going for a clothesline and then a duckling elbow. The timing is really bad. Wait a second, Samurai kind of running out of gas here. Apparently, he has not been training for any of those triathlons as of late.
Yep.
He's checking his pulse. The referee, Sparky Ballard, our senior official, checking on Samurai. Okay, I think he's going to be okay.
Oh, he's getting the second win.
There we go. Samurai now charging off the ropes. Duck under a right arm. A back elbow. Hip toss. Oh, and Caden Anthony takes down Sir Samurai. And Anthony goes for the cover. One. Gets himself a one count.
Sparky Ballard right there to make the count. Always in excellent position.
That says so much about Sparky Ballard's experience, and that is why he retains the senior official status here at APW. Oh, rolling snapmare.
Oh, a senton bomb by Tsunami on Sir Samurai. Two big men.
Great line of the leg. Two. And a two count only, kicked out with authority.
Samurai going for the tag, but he's in the wrong corner. I hope he knows that.
And in and out tags. Now Caden Anthony, the legal man.
Oh, a big atomic drop. Oh, followed by the spinning heel kick by Caden Anthony.
And he held him while that spinning heel kick came in. Goes for the cover. Two. And a two count. That left shoulder popping right up.
So close. Caden Anthony is so close to a pin there. Brian Tannen on his way in to make the save, though.
That tag team specialist that is Caden Anthony and Tsunami. You can tell they have a lot of experience as a team. But Honor Society's member, Sir Samurai. Oh, the DDT! It planted him right at the top of his head, Shane.
Vicious DDT. Samurai needs to go for the pin right now. He's going to go for the tag.
I think this is the smart move. He doesn't have a whole lot of gas in the tank. And it looks like Samurai, if he makes the tag to a fresh Brian Tannen. Brian Tannen now, the legal man.
Oh, big forearm to Tsunami there on the apron. Caden Anthony now gets a clubbing forearm to the back as well.
Right across the back. I'll tell you what, if that doesn't make your legs go numb from this youngster. And Tannen now scoops up Caden Anthony. Holds him a little long and just drives him into the mat with a vicious body slam.
Cover one, two. Only a two count though, nope. Tannen still got just a little bit too much left in the tank.
Tannen scores that two count after that vicious body slam. Tannen, so impressive since debuting here at All Pro Wrestling. Oh, back elbow. Remember, we saw him not so very long ago in the APW Young Lions Cup. Cover the grapevine. And again, another two count. Sparky Ballard again right in position.
Tannen most recently suffering a loss to J.R. Kratos here at Gym Wars. But, you know, an impressive showing nonetheless.
Absolutely. It's like an uphill battle when you're going against a juggernaut that is J.R. Kratos. But he showed himself to be a very impressive young man, and I believe he's got a bright future here at All Pro Wrestling. And that boot right to the throat of Caden Anthony.
Oh, Brian Tannen getting the choke in.
Oh, a little bit of old school Honor Society. He has absolutely had a little bit of Sir Samurai training.
Not sure why they're going this route, but...
Well, Samurai believes that the rules don't necessarily have to be broken. They can just be bent a little.
Sir Samurai, make no mistake that... Sir Samurai, while the fans love him now, he's been one of the more devious men in NorCal professional wrestling history.
He goes for another cover. One, two, and a kick out. Yes, he has been known to have a diabolical streak a mile wide. But the crowd seems to really love the man now. And it's not so much that he's changed. It's just that
the respect for the many years of entertainment he's provided to the fans.
Absolutely. Shoulder tackles by Brian Tannen. Oh, here he goes for a
three-point stance.
Oh, and that shoulder right into the midsection of Caden Anthony.
Into the guts, JJ, right into the guts. One, two, only a two count. Brian Tannen just moving way too slow. Giving Caden Anthony an opportunity to catch his wind, make that kick out right at the last second.
Irish whip, oh, off the ropes, duck under, and a back body drop by Tannen.
Oh, Caden almost got the tag. Tannen again moving too slow.
Dragged him right back to the center of the ring, but that did not stop Tsunami from breaking the count. Ballard throwing him to the outside. Not the legal man. Inside the ring, Brian Tannen picks Caden Anthony back up. Off the ropes. Oh, swings for the clothesline, nobody home. Up and over for a tilt-a-whirl.
Again, the inexperience of Brian Tannen really telegraphed that clothesline, and Caden Anthony able to take advantage.
Oh, Caden Anthony.
That was a mess right there. And Caden Anthony just went for that.
Well, that tilt-a-whirl absolutely must have thrown him off because he did not know where he was right then. He was too dizzy to make that work.
Caden Anthony just looked really out of it right now.
Two. And a kick out at two.
Barely able to power out.
Well, obviously the damage has been done, and that's why he wasn't able to hit that maneuver. If he would have hit it, I'm pretty sure that Brian Tannen might have been beaten right then.
Brian Tannen back to the headlock. It's rather unorthodox move at this point. You know, I would think that, you know, you want to continue working on the back the way he's been, the back of the midsection, and now he's going for the head.
Well, who knows what kind of training Sir Samurai has put into his head since joining the Honor Society, but aligning himself with Samurai was a smart move. Anthony breaking the count with those back elbows. Oh, and he gets caught in midair by Brian Tannen. Drops down. Oh, it just drops it down. And now at this point, he has to make a tag.
You're absolutely right. Both men are in desperate need of a tag at this point in the match. Caden Anthony a little bit worse for the wear, but Brian Tannen definitely in more familiar territory in that ring there than Caden Anthony. Caden Anthony has a lot farther to go.
The crowd here in the Bakersfield Dome can feel it. A tag, both men now fresh. Here comes Samurai, took under clothesline for Tsunami. Shoulder tackle, and down goes Sir Samurai on another one. Tsunami is on a house of fire right now.
Big body slam. What's he going for here? Tsunami setting up for something.
The handkerchief comes off. A little John Cena here in the Bakersfield Dome. Drop of the elbow.
Goes for the pin. One, two.
Oh, Brian Tannen breaking the count.
Sparky Valor just a little bit off his game here.
Clothesline from Caden Anthony. And now Samurai throws him to the outside. Sir Samurai picks up Tsunami, and that's not an easy feat up onto his shoulder. Oh, Tsunami drops back down, tries to judge it. And now Tsunami grappling with Sir Samurai off the ropes.
He's got him up in that backbreaker position.
Oh, double team maneuver with the leg drop in midair. Two.
This is it. Tsunami retains. Tsunami and Caden Anthony, otherwise known as Suitcase. Tsunami with a pin to retain the tag team title.
Suke, very impressive, defeating the Honor Society here in the Bakersfield Dome. And we will get some hate mail from the WWE about that gimmick infringement. Victorious over the Honor Society, Shane Stoley in the very final show here at the Bakersfield Dome.
Some fantastic action, but that's not all we've got today. Later on, we've got Chris Masters challenging for the All-Pro Wrestling Universal Heavyweight Championship. But up next, we've got a rematch from the Young Lions Cup as J.R. Kratos takes on Damien Grundy. That's going to be fantastic, JJ.
It's looking to be a great show. The main event later on tonight, Chris Masters, because of his status as being a true worldwide superstar, being granted an opportunity for the richest prize in our sport, a real wrestling championship.
Oh, look at this, a little bit of dissension. Sorry to cut you off, but Sir Samurai and Brian Tannen not very happy with each other here.
Well, it's understandable. They didn't win. The championships retained by Sue Kay, you don't win them all.
I can understand, the frustration for sure. But, the Honor Society doesn't usually work that way, I thought.
Well, a shake of the hands and, cooler heads prevail. There's going to be tomorrow. There's always another opportunity for the Honor. Hey, wait a second! Brian Tannen clothesline Samurai right out of his boots.
Nasty clothesline. Brian Tannen now showing off for the crowd. I'm not quite sure where this is coming from.
There was absolutely nothing honorable about what Brian Tannen just did to Sir Samurai. So some people apparently can't handle defeat.
I guess not. We see it all the time, but it still surprises me when it happens. I don't know why.
Tell you what, of all the people in APW that you want to pick a fight with, I would absolutely not choose to pick a fight with Sir Samurai.
Sir Samurai is having the worst place on earth. I am so embarrassed to be here. So you know what I'm going to do? I grab my tank and make like a tree and get out of here, all right?
Make like a tree and get out of here. Is this guy serious?
Okay, it's a little cliche.
The 50s called, they want their joke back. Well, great, now the 90s called, they wanted that joke back.
That was the 80s that called, the 70s. No. Well, there you have it. He couldn't handle defeat and clotheslined Sir Samurai. Sir Samurai is not one to forget.
Ladies and gentlemen, the smartest man in professional wrestling, Sir Samurai.
A legitimate shoot IQ of 217. The man is so smart, so intelligent, a genius. And I'm sure this thing isn't over between Brian Tannen, a now former member of the Honor Society, and that man, Sir Samurai.
When we come back to APW Gym Wars, it's me, J.R. Kratos, versus Damien Grundy. This match has been long awaited for, and I've been waiting, and I'm ready. Damien, you're going down.
Do you have what it takes to become a pro wrestler? The APW Bootcamp Training School is accepting applicants for pro wrestlers, managers, valets, and referees. All Pro Wrestling, home of APW Bootcamp, is where future legends are born. For the last 19 years, APW has been the leader in talent development. Top graduates include The Great Khali, Crash Holly, Spike Dudley. For your free brochure, call us at 510-785-8396.
APW faithful, get ready for the immovable force, meaning the irresistible object.
It's going to be a battle of the bulls, as a guy that once loves barbecue sauce once used to say. It's going to be, these guys are going to pummel the hell out of each other. There's no other way to say it.
The term slobber knocker comes to mind.
That's a good one.
I'm probably going to get more mail on the gimmick infringement
all
stuff.
All kinds of hate mail.
We had that earlier from the You Can't See Me from Suitcase. As J.R. Kratos takes on the destroyer of man, Damien Grundy.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Oakland, California, he weighs in at 280 pounds, a member.
Now take quick notice, Damien Grundy, the destroyer of man, coming here to the Bakersfield Dome, sans Matthew Thiel, the greatest mind in professional wrestling.
Well, the big thing is that Damien Grundy is so willing to follow instruction. And it just, I think, you know, Matt Thiel going off to spa days, getting facials with Perry Von Vicious was just, you know, Damien Grundy should have spoke up. He should have said something. He should have made it known that he felt he needed Matthew Thiel at ringside with him for this big match against a beast like J.R. Kratos.
Well, Thiel apparently feels like the loss of the Worldwide Internet Championship is too much for his charge, Perry Von Vicious, to handle. So they have taken this day spa day, and it really has gotten out of hand when he should be taking care of Damien Grundy and this huge match against this beast, this juggernaut in J.R. Kratos.
J.R. Kratos, it gets better and better every time he steps in the ring, and it is more and more impressive. Just a fantastic physique and just fire like nobody else.
It's funny because another wrestler in another company says, feed me more. This guy literally eats the competition.
An impressive specimen makes his way to the ring. Of course, both of these guys have incredible physiques.
Kratos cuts an imposable figure. I mean, this guy is a legend. He's a myth. Rumored, but not believed. But believe it, when he comes to the ring, he brings an intensity all his own.
A Damien Grundy, no slouch either. I mean, just a fantastic physique. We saw a few weeks ago against Will Rude, he did that standing backflip.
I was blown away by the fact that the Destroyer of Man pulled out something that you would have never seen. The agility for this young stud here at APW. And keep in mind that APW training That means that he has the fundamentals to get the job done when wrestling in the ring. A lot of people always see him as a big bull, but he can get it done. And here we go, nose to nose with these two behemoths.
Nope, shove off there.
Oh, and a slap to the face from Grundy to Kratos.
Nasty show of disrespect right back from J.R. Kratos.
A receipt and then a couple of right hands from Kratos. An Irish whip. Grundy. Oh, Grundy picks the foot right to the face. Oh, and then levels him with a clothesline.
Nasty clothesline. J.R. Kratos staggered already.
Oh, a Samoan drop.
Nasty, nasty step there. Damien trying to end it early.
Grundy goes for the cover. Apparently, Grundy does not need Matthew Thiel. He's got a game plan employed, and he's sticking to it.
Sparky Ballard warding off those close fists there. But Damien Grundy just gives him a mean look. Now J.R. Kratos just trying to fight back here.
Kratos just pummeling the midsection of Damien Grundy. But Grundy able to power out of... Oh, a high cross body off the middle rope out of nowhere. Kratos also has a lot of agility that sometimes is overlooked for his power.
Big clothesline. Yeah, we saw him do that over the top rope. That plancha on Brian Tannen a few weeks ago just absolutely leveled him.
And it was out of nowhere. And that's what he's bringing to the table right now.
Oh, another big forearm by J.R. Kratos sends Damien Grundy back into the corner. He's giving him too much time here.
Here comes Kratos. Oh, with an avalanche splash and nobody home.
Oh, big boot by Grundy.
Oh, and Grundy plants him with a DDT. A la Jake the Snake Roberts, the way that he just drove him head first into the mat.
Both men slow to get up, fighting back to their feet here.
Well, that's the thing, when you have such body mass, as each of these men do, being larger individuals, it's a whole lot harder to get that weight back up after taking a pummeling. Oh!
Big back body drop.
And he landed right on his patukas. That's the behind.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I thought you saw something I didn't.
No. No, it's a Yiddish word. Not that I'm Jewish.
What's Kratos setting up for that big spear here?
Oh, he moved right out of the way. Grundy scouted it.
Very well scouted. Damien Grundy, masterful, dodged that move perfectly. And Kratos in a bad way here now.
Sparky Ballard checking on Kratos on the outside. And at this point, the count will begin.
Kratos trying to shake. Oh, Damien Grundy running out.
Grundy taking the fight to the outside here in the Bakersfield Dome.
Hits him with that big knee, follows it up with a throat to the guardrail.
You take out a man's throat, and it's hard to get that win, and it is hard to think when you have that type of pain going through your body.
Damien Grundy now being fired into the ring steps.
And there is absolutely no give on the steel ring steps as Grundy's face bounced off of it. And that skull, you heard the hard thud as J.R. Kratos is pummeling away on the Destroyer of Man.
Well, whips him into the ring post. I was not expecting that. I thought he was gonna try and send him into the guardrail.
Kratos just staying right on top of Grundy. Just methodically charging in. Irish whip reversal, oh! And J.R. Kratos meets the ring post as well. You hear Sparky Ballard calling on the outside, and Kratos literally just inches away from the crowd here in the Bakersfield Dome, getting to see this world-class one-on-one APW match.
J.R. Kratos very slowly trying to catch his breath. Oh, here comes Damien Grundy with the chair.
Oh, the steel chair coming into play, and Kratos blocked it. And he's got a hold of that chair.
Oh, Damien Grundy able to dodge as well. He's super kick.
And Kratos to the over the top and to the outside of the steel barricades. And Grundy is looking a little hurt. This when you have matches of this caliber with two individuals such as Grundy and Kratos, damage is done to bodies. You cannot take this kind of punishment without feeling lasting effects.
Out into the fans, Kratos gets thrown into the chairs. Where Sparky Ballard, I can hear him in the background. Want to know what, I mean, is he administering a count?
As we sit here in the Bakersfield Dome, You can hear the thuds of the flesh-on-flesh hitting and punching and kicking. This thing is getting very violent.
They've gone through the barricade, JJ. This Damien Grundy has got to be in a world of pain right now.
Each one of these hard shots, I literally feel in my body.
Oh, Damien Grundy up and over the top. Oh!
Oh, Grundy shoves Kratos right into those steel steps. And he took that low in the knees.
Like we said, there's been bad blood between these men for quite some time, and it's definitely, it looks like it's coming to a head here today.
Well, in the chair shot, and nobody home. Kratos right out of the way. In the 2012 Young Lions Cup, Kratos handed Damien Grundy a defeat, a narrow defeat, but a defeat nonetheless.
Damien Grundy has held that against Kratos since that time.
He's not used to ever dealing with anyone who has the power that he possesses. So to be evenly matched such as this, it's a little unnerving. It's a little unnerving, excuse me.
It definitely does have to throw you off your game, that's for sure.
The Savat kick from the Destroyer of Man.
I have to give Damien Grundy the edge in agility here, just slightly though.
And also the fact that both men's careers are young. They're early. They haven't been wrestling very long. But already each man has, in their own way, made very big impacts on
They've gone to the back, it looks like. I can't see from here.
If we can get a camera to follow the action, Sparky Ballard in the ring has called
the bell. It's got to be a double count.
Double count out. Each man has taken this fight to the back, and unfortunately the fans are robbed.
This is the man himself, the man who was T-Bowing before there was ever a T-Bow, the man who was peck popping before the Rock, the masterpiece himself, Chris Masters. And I'm here to tell you, up next, Timothy Thatcher and the Masterpiece, one-on-one for the APW title. You are looking at the next APW champion in the Masterpiece.
Are you or your son or daughter celebrating a birthday soon? There's no better way to celebrate a birthday than to throw the birthday person a pro wrestling themed birthday party. We have several packages available, including renting our facility with a customized pro wrestling show. Bring your birthday cake and invite your guests to attend a private pro wrestling birthday party. If you are interested in having all pro wrestling be a part of your birthday celebration, give us a call at 510-785-8396 or visit the website at www.allprowrestling.com.
Corner, but no reversal. Oh, look at that. Oh, we got a cover. One, two, no. A little roll up right there by Kendrick, not able to get a three count. Oh, a chin breaker right there. That's going to affect his singing. Thank goodness. Oh, could it be? No, I thought he was going to go for that slice bread number two, but look at this. Referee having no idea right there. Oh, tornado DDT, nicely done. Hooks a leg, we got a cover. One, two, almost a count of three. Pulling him up by his hair, but you know what? Uh-oh. Oh, ducking that Enziguri. Billy Blade has taken out many opponents with that. We're gonna have it. Slice blade number two, no. Oh, on the outside, Kevin Devine. Billy Blade now on the second rope. And, oh my goodness, spinning neck breaker off that second rope. Got a cover. One, two, three. Got him. Time of the fall, 7 minutes, 14 seconds. Oh, come on, Billy, that's enough. Oh, no, he's just driving that ladder right there. And, oh, what's going on? What's going on here? The light's going out? And what the hell? And the lights have gone out. And wait, on the Tagtron, what the hell? Ladies and gentlemen, I think we're being hacked.
Logan LeGlade, Matt Larkin. Congratulations on your big win. You look like a $1 million out there. I can see, obviously, you're getting ready for our huge match on October 27th at Terror Rising. Well, you challenged me to accept your stipulation of the ladder match. Well, I will on one condition. You accept my stipulation that whoever loses the match gets their head shaved. Yeah!
Ladies and gentlemen, he just hacked the Tactron. I mean, Matt Hardy. Is Billy Blade gonna? Is Billy Blade gonna do it? Is Billy Blade gonna put his hair on the line? Slice spread number two right there in the ring on Kevin Devine. Billy Blade victorious here tonight, but at least a small measure of revenge right there by Brian Kendrick. Well, it's Kevin Devine who essentially cost him the match when he tried to go. Matt Hardy's losing his hair. I think he accepts the stipulation.
APW faithful, that is next week. The main event is going to be Billy Blade versus Matt Hardy in a hair versus hair ladder match. JJ, what are your thoughts on this one?
Matt Hardy making his debut for APW. Hair on the line in a ladder match. It's going to be exciting. Make sure to tune in next week to APW Gym Wars. Also next week, the Unified Tag Team Championship on the line as Suke, who were victorious earlier on tonight, defend against Shannon and Shannon, the Ballard Brothers.
I don't know how many shots these Ballard Brothers are going to be able to finagle out of the Unified Tag Team Championship committee, but they're getting one more.
Well, it's much deserved for the Ballard Brothers. Also next week, one-on-one, we see Nate Rules in action as he takes on the Golden Boy, Dylan Drake.
Nate Rules, one half of arguably one of the greatest tag teams in the history of all pro wrestling, Ego, taking on one of the greatest Universal Heavyweight Champions.
APW faithful, it is now time for the main event on this week's edition of APW Gym Wars in the Bakersfield Dome. The Universal Heavyweight Championship on the line and the Bakersfield Dome debut of the British Messiah, Timothy Thatcher, our APW Universal Champion.
Of course, Timothy Thatcher viewed as a bit of an outsider here coming in for this one show. And, you know, Chris Masters has wrestled for Vendetta Pro and All Pro Wrestling quite a few times down south, so I mean, Timothy Thatcher looked at as almost someone that the fans don't like.
Funny enough, Chris Masters actually has the home field advantage, and the crowd is going to more than likely be more hostile towards Timothy Thatcher because he is seen as an outsider, whereas Chris Masters has ingratiated himself with the hearts of the people here in Bakersfield.
Timothy Thatcher going into this just very, very focused on his opponent, not giving the fans much attention like he usually does to Hayward.
Well, what an amazing opportunity for Chris Masters, the challenger, to be able to be granted an APW Universal Heavyweight Championship match, which so many people have strived for and worked their entire careers for. But because of his status as a former WWE superstar, and really having wrestled all over the world, he is granted a huge opportunity to perhaps cement himself as the man in APW.
So many people just are chumming at the bit to get a shot at that Universal Heavyweight Championship, and now Chris Masters is at the top of that list. It's a fantastic, and not only is it a fantastic opportunity for Chris Masters, but it's a fantastic opportunity for Timothy Thatcher as well to prove himself against someone the stature of Chris Masters, just a fantastic feather in the cap of the Universal Heavyweight Champion.
Well, because he wrestles here for APW, he knows all about world-class talent, but he has never been to the ring with anybody quite like the Masterpiece. Chris Masters does not look like he has had any ring rust since leaving World Wrestling Entertainment.
He's very, very confident here, I've got to say. That's a little bit of a surprise. You know, knowing the history and knowing about Timothy Thatcher the way you and I do, you'd think that Chris Masters would be a little bit more focused.
Well, hopefully Masters has done his homework on Timothy Thatcher, because he is not someone you want to take lightly. The APW Universal Heavyweight Champion did not get to that position on two occasions without having to literally tear through competition.
Chris, I'm amazed. Chris Masters looks overconfident to me. I think this could definitely play to a disadvantage for Chris Masters. He looks overly confident in his ability to win this match today.
And in complete contrast, Timothy Thatcher looks completely aware and completely involved in what is going to happen in this match.
Well, Timothy Thatcher knows that this is going to be an uphill battle. Even as the champion, he's definitely going to have a fight in front of him.
Champion not used to hearing that reaction. It's been quite...
I would disagree. There were many years where the fans were less than thrilled with Timothy Thatcher. It's just been a little while.
That's what I was trying to say. Not used to that reaction in quite some time. He has been used to the adulation of the fans here at APW. So he really does not have the home field advantage this time around. And that might put a danger on his grasp of the APW Universal Heavyweight Championship.
I don't know about that. Timothy Thatcher seems focused here tonight. I think if anything, the crowd not being behind him is driving Timothy Thatcher to prove himself, just like he does every single month he steps in the ring at the All-Pro Wrestling Garage.
And that there is what it's all about. The APW Universal Heavyweight Championship, held by so many greats, and now held by, right now, pound for pound, the best professional wrestler in the world today, Timothy Thatcher. Chant reverberating throughout the Bakersfield Dome.
Chris, with the crowd firmly behind Chris Masters here today, Timothy Thatcher does not look very pleased.
A little known fact that Chris Masters started his career right here in Bakersfield 10 years ago before going on to fame and fortune in WWE.
It's a fantastic opportunity for him to cement the legacy of the Bakersfield Dome here. That is, they celebrate the swan song of the Bakersfield Dome.
To have the APW Universal Heavyweight Championship change hands on the last night that professional wrestling is held at the Dome. What a huge treat that would be for some fans to be able to take home those memories.
And for Chris Masters as well, to take home that title, JJ.
Absolutely. Collar and elbow tie-up. Champion and challenger.
Chris Masters has the strength advantage here on Timothy Thatcher.
And a slight height advantage. We're going to have a clean break right now.
Now that's pretty rare. You know, not too many guys that have the height advantage on Thatcher.
And there you go. Thatcher ducking under the ropes to allow himself a little bit of breathing room. Okay, the APW Universal Heavyweight Championship on the line.
Thatcher complaining about Masters being a little bit greasy there.
A little liberal use of the baby oil. And a go behind from Thatcher into a side headlock. And look at that, as Thatcher, the champion, wrenches down on that headlock.
Oh, Masters has... Oh. Thought he was going to go for a backdrop or something there. Just throwing Matt Thatcher off his game.
Grabbed a hold of that side bear hug with those massive arms. He did not get to be called a masterpiece for nothing. This man is well-defined, obviously spends a lot of time in the gym.
Trying to fight out of this side headlock now.
Able to turn out of it.
Oh.
Oh, and a little handful of the hair brings him back right into position for that side headlock.
Taking a page out of the samurai book there. Masters fires him off. Big shoulder block.
And down goes Thatcher, the champion. Goes to the outside for a little powder.
Thatcher scoots out. Takes a little bit of a break to collect his thoughts here. And then goes out his jaw jacket with the fans.
APW faithful, you'll notice that the champion is wrestling a little bit of a different style. And that is to be noted as sometimes when a hostile crowd, a crowd that is not behind you, you will change up your game a little bit and employ a little bit of a different style.
Yeah, well, I mean, if the crowd's being jerks, you want to stick it to them, right?
Absolutely.
There you go. And that's exactly what's happening there.
And Thatcher back into the ring. Here we go, the main event this week on Gym Wars.
The Masters just looks so cocky, it just amazes me.
The confidence just oozing off the challenger right now. Will that be his downfall tonight here in Bakersfield? Kawanobu tie-up.
And well, again, Thatcher absolutely a cerebral wrestler. So, I mean, I think that, you know, the mind games that Masters is playing right now, well, it looks like
there was not a clean break that time. A chop by Thatcher. Oh, and a receipt by the Masterpiece.
Definitely trying to cave in the chest of Tim Thatcher.
A little strut from Masterpiece Chris Masters.
Another nasty chop. Thatcher shoving Sparky in the way so he doesn't have to take a third.
It's got to be said, Bakersfield has got some of the loudest woos I've ever heard. Oh, back elbow from the Masterpiece.
Thatcher again out to the ringside here. Doesn't know how to handle Chris Masters here. And Chris Masters' confidence apparently was well served here in the opening minutes of this bout.
Well, Timothy Thatcher, the British Messiah, utilizing that presence of mind, having that ring awareness, taking a powder to the outside. It is not a good position. You're angry. You're not thinking correctly. By taking a moment to yourself on the outside, you're able to get your win and to rethink your strategy. And you know that the crowd not being behind him has thrown his game off quite a bit.
That's thrown his game off. The confidence of Chris Masters has thrown his game off. Just this is not a good start to this match for Thatcher.
Well, most people, when finding themselves on the opposite side of the ring of the British Messiah, Timothy Thatcher, are not as confident as the Masterpiece is.
That's for sure. I mean, they know they've got a long road ahead of them, but Chris Masters, he just looks like he's ready to have a good time. Well, not anymore.
When you sign up to wrestle against Tim Thatcher, you know that it's not going to be an easy night at work. Those European uppercuts finding their mark on the Masterpiece.
Now he's got that cravat locked in, cutting off the air and the circulation to the brain.
And look at that, as Thatcher using his foot to drive the back of the knee and drive Masterpiece down. And now all of Thatcher's upper body weight utilizing that cravat right now and cutting that wind off, just as Mr. Stoley said a moment ago.
Oh, Masters fires in with a big right hand to the ribs.
Able to break those locked fingers from the cravat. And now, Masterpiece Chris Masters, an Irish whip.
Oh,
reversal by Thatcher.
Reversal.
Oh, flying shoulder tackle. And down goes the champion.
Oh, Masters setting up for that. Master.
There we go, the Master lock. Oh, he wasn't able to lock it.
Thatcher scoots out, though.
Again to the outside. Narrowly avoiding that Master lock.
Thatcher desperately trying to control the pace here. Of course, Chris Masters, you know, used to work it a little bit faster than Timothy Thatcher does, and Thatcher very slow and methodical and picks his opponents apart.
Some mighty big men have fallen to that Master lock, and he was very close to being able to interlace those fingers. If it happens, you gotta wonder if Timothy Thatcher would be able to break the hold.
You know, Thatcher is a master of submission holds, so you've got to know that he's got to be ready to be able to counter that Master lock. Nelson Master Lock. Absolutely, Thatcher's got that scouted. Oh my gosh, he didn't have this scouted though.
Handful of hair. There's no way to really fight that. Pulling Thatcher back up. Oh, and then draping that arm and shoulder right over the top rope. Trying to separate that arm. It's going to be hard. Oh, driving the arm into the mat. It's going to be hard to put the Master Lock on.
Oh, he's going for that Thatcher stretch. He's going to try and go for it early.
Look at that, as he's wrenching away, is the champion. And the pain is etched right in the face of the challenger. Look at him scoot an inch and claw his way to the ropes. Sparky Ballard right there breaks the hold.
Oh, and now Masters out to the outside to try and catch his thoughts here, but Thatcher follows him out.
Thatcher playing the smart move, not giving him any time.
Wearing down the arm. This is classic Thatcher. I hope Masters had this scouted, but you never know. I mean, this is Thatcher is always just so methodical about wearing down that shoulder and the arm of his opponent.
Thatcher is like a rabid pit bull right now, just attacking a weak spot. Look at that, just methodically plodding and going right for that arm. drives that kick in, and now the Universal Champion does it again, and now going for the cover. Gets a two count, unfortunately could not hold him down. Look at that, just wrenching away on the challenger. The style is absolutely the same. Even though it's changed, it's the same. The man still knows how to wrestle.
Masters trying to power back up, get back to his feet here. Thatcher,
he's able to break the hold, and Thatcher goes right back into it. And look at those big right hands and takes down the champion.
Thatcher absolutely driven, no matter how many. Masters keeps throwing in those right hands, and Thatcher just keeps going right back for that arm. Look, here he goes again.
European uppercut, and look at that. Trying to separate that arm even further. Masterpiece, Chris Masters is hurting right now. Thatcher goes right back into it. And right now he's acting like a shark with blood because he is staying right on top of that injured arm.
He's definitely circling the body in the water for sure.
I alluded to it a little while ago, but he is just like a shark with blood because once he's got a taste of it, he is just locked onto it. And you got to imagine that right now ligaments are being torn. Muscles are being pulled. Chris Masters is having a hard time keeping his shoulders off the mat. He's in so much pain, you got to imagine that all of his thought processes are going to that injury and how to prevent it from being hurt anymore. Sometimes the body will shut down.
Thatcher just trying desperately to get any way he can to get out of this. He's maneuvering his body parallel to Thatcher's, and it's definitely helped take the pressure off of that, the elbow there.
Look at that, as he tries to break it at those huge arms and unable to do it. Wait, Masterpiece, Chris Masters. Oh, what a sidewalk slam for the champion, Timothy Thatcher. A last-ditch effort to break the hold. But will he be able to shake off the effects of all the damage that's been done to his arm?
Masters trying to drag himself to the rope so he can have a little bit of assistance in getting back to his feet.
The first man to his feet is going to have the early advantage. And it looks like Masterpiece is not going to be the man.
Oh, but, you could be mistaken. Oh. Big atomic drop there.
The inverted atomic drop. And then levels him with a clothesline. The challenger right where he needs to be with those clotheslines. He's getting that adrenaline pumping again. And he goes for an Irish whip, but Timothy Thatcher reverses it. Oh, into the power slam.
One-handed power slam. Two.
Oh, and that shoulder coming right up.
That was amazing. I don't know if you caught that, JJ. That was a one-handed power slam. That injured arm was ineffective for Chris Masters, so he did that with one arm.
It was amazing, but can he put the master lock on with one arm? I think not.
It looks like he's going to power through the pain here.
Maybe we'll see it. Here he goes.
Thatcher doing everything.
Oh, and look at Thatcher.
It again.
Smartly goes right for that arm, that injured wing.
Driving his elbow into the shoulder there. Hyper-extending the muscles in the shoulder there.
And look at that, Thatcher using all of his body weight as he's trying to prone himself over the arm. Thatcher having a hard time keeping Masterpiece down. All of that conditioning and rolls out of it right now. Here comes Thatcher. No, the master lock! He's got it locked in. The fingers are interlaced. Are we going to have a new... No, wait a second. Sparky Ballard's head connected with Timothy Thatcher's.
Oh, low blow. Thatcher with a low blow on Chris Masters.
A cradle. Two, three. He got it. Timothy Thatcher retains over Chris Masters. Still the APW Universal Heavyweight Champion chain. Event here in the Bakersfield Dome. APW Gym Wars, Timothy Thatcher retains the APW Universal Heavyweight Championship. What an incredible night for Bakersfield Dome. For Shane Stoley, I'm JJ Purdom. We'll see you next time here at APW Gym Wars.